Sometimes things just get fouled up, or a student asks a question that you don't know the answer to, and then you just can't be afraid to say, I don't know the answer, I'll go find out, and then come back at the beginning of class the next week, with the answer. And I've found that students don't mind that. And in the classes that I teach, a programming class or a database class, there's room for some amount of experimentation. And I don't usually like to say to students, what would happen if we did this? I prefer not to say, well, go try it and then come back and tell me what it does. I try to be flexible about if the student says, well, we have this database, what would happen if we tried to do this on the tables or modify the data in this way or try this operation? I try to be open to, just doing that in class. Well, I don't know what it's going to do. And, you can never know every combination of what's going to happen when you try something. So you just try it in class and you see what happens. And, maybe I'm willing to venture a guess so the students can see that it's okay to hypothesize and then find out, make your best guess from what you know, and then maybe you'll be right, maybe you'll be wrong. But then you do the experiment to find out whether it's, find out which way it goes. And then, we all get to learn something. So they get to see me occasionally wrong about things, which is fine, but willing to go and find the information and say, okay, I was wrong about this, but here's what it does. Now we've found something out. And hopefully that makes them more curious about figuring things out for themselves as well.